Good morning, this is Vera from Fiber Tours and we are back in St. Petersburg, and today we decided to take you to one of the most magnificent royal estates in Russia, or maybe even in the world. It's Catherine's Palace. And in order to make you come here, please note that Catherine's Palace is included in the list of the UNESCO World Heritage Sites as the part of the historical city center of St. Petersburg, so don't even think of skipping it in your travel plan. But just to remind you, we already visited with you five UNESCO sites during my travels. Let's remember all of them really quickly. It was Moscow Kremlin and Red Square, Kazan Kremlin, an island of Sviyazhsk, Novodevichy Monastery, and of course Lake Baikal. So this is our number six, the historical city center of St. Petersburg and its suburbs. So visit this palace, I don't know, because it's simply stunning. When you are inside, you will need to put on your shoes this shoes proof in order to protect the beautiful floors of the Catherine's Palace. I feel myself like a princess. Is there anybody to dance with me? Oh.
The building of this palace was initiated by the second wife of Peter the Great, Catherine the First, and that's why it holds her name. But actually, way more influence in its today's look was brought by her daughter, Elizabeth the First, who just loved the so-called Russian Baroque style with all its pomp, wealth, and abundance. She reconstructed pretty much everything and made it the pleasure palace for hunting, masquerading, and balls.
The palace itself admires with its opulent design, with all these wall holes, you know, and the gilding everywhere. But of course, the biggest treasure of Catherine's Palace is the Amber Room. It was gifted in 1701 to Peter the Great by his ally, the Prussian king, Wilhelm the First, I think. And we're about to enter it because during the Second World War, it was disappeared. And then it was reconstructed by the Russian masters and gifted to St. Petersburg in 2003 for the 300th anniversary of St. Petersburg. We will go there, but we are not allowed to take any pictures inside or any videos. So, I don't know, maybe we will find a picture for you. Let's go. Located in a very beautiful St. Petersburg suburb called Pushkin, or the former name of Pushkin is Tsarskoye Selo, or the Tsar's Village. Pushkin is located only 15 kilometers away from the city, and usually tourists, in order to get to Catherine's Palace, use, well, car transfers, buses, and trains. And actually, this railway was the first one in the Russian Empire and connected St. Petersburg and this fashionable royal residence already in 1840. We have been already with you to Peterhof and now able to compare the scope of construction of these two residences. Of course, both of them are absolutely amazing, but I think what attracts in Peterhof is this famous, unique fountain system. But what comes to the palaces, to my opinion, Catherine's Palace is a little bit more attractive and impressive, you know, with this, all these colors and everything. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say that, but well, here it is. It's been a great walk along the halls of the Catherine's Palace, and even though I didn't find anybody to dance with me, still it was really enjoyable. And also the walk through the Catherine's Park. Actually, we wanted to rent a boat and to sail on the lake, but it wasn't available today, unfortunately, which is a pity. But still, you need to understand, and then you realize that when you are here in such great royal residences, you need to take your time to feel this amazing atmosphere, to walk through the alleys and the paths of the park, just to enjoy it. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions left, please leave them below in the comments. This was Vera from Fiber Tours, and we will see you next week. Bye bye. Я люблю тебя, жизнь, и надеюсь, что это взаимно.